Alright guys, so here we are. We're going to do a hopefully a pretty quick demo showing how to climb up and down with a bolt system. I'm wearing today everything that I would usually have if I was going to go hunt, either, you know, late season spring hog hunting or, you know, early archery for deer. Got my, you know, long sleeve camouflage pants with a cargo pocket. If you replace this with a camouflage t-shirt, ball cap, I got my pack, I got my bow. Just outside the frame, you'll see when I walk up to the tree behind me, tree right here, you'll see I'm wearing my saddle. Everything is set up how it would be if I was going out on a hunt. So I've got my woodpecker drill in my cargo pockets. I got my saddle on. It's got my ring of steps, my carbon fiber bolts. I've got built into my pack, I've got my gear hoist to pull my bow up. So we're going to do one trip up a tree and we're going to drill as we go. We're going to drill 10 bolts and we're going to step up and set a ring of steps, set in with a tether, put my gear holder on, hang the bow, hang my pack, everything. I'll try to signal when I'm done with everything so y'all get a good idea for what the time on that was. Then I'm going to climb down, pulling the bolts as I go. Then we're going to do a second climb, all right, and we're just going to put the bolts in the holes so y'all get an idea of what it would be like if you had drilled a tree and you were coming back and using those bolts. Then we're going to do a third climb. Because I love you guys, when I climb down the second time, I'm going to leave the bolts in. I'm just going to climb straight down so you can see what that looks like. And then I'm going to do one more climb up just with bolts already set in the tree, like if I had preset something with grade 8 bolts. So we're going to show you all the different possibilities, every different way you can do it. And we're going to start right now. so you can see, that's a whole climb up, that's a whole climb down. We're gonna go ahead. That's fresh drilling. That would be like a typical hunt. If I was going in somewhere and I'd never hunted before, I wanted to go up, come back down, do another quick climb. We're just gonna put the bolts in as we go. Bolts set. Now all I have to do is come up, put my ring and step on the tree. Put the jack. Alright, that's the second climb. That's showing what it would be like if I had already drilled that tree. I usually mark it with three reflective tacks and a triangle so I can come back to it. You can drill those in October, and right now it's still March, and the tree that I drilled in early October, I was still able to hunt it tail end of March. That works really, really well. The holes, you know, they do grow up over the growing season. Now stuff's starting to green up and grow. So, you know, you won't have much longer. You'll have to drill them out again. Now, this is going to be my third and final climb. I'm going to show what it would be like just if you were to go ahead and climb up to the top of that 10th bolt. I didn't climb all the way up to the top of the 10th bolt. I just set them, and I didn't go through the whole process of setting up my ring of steps and tether and everything like that. So, we're just going to climb up. You can see how quick it takes to just walk up to a tree and climb up 10 preset bolts. We're going to climb down, pull the bolts, and then we're going to wrap it up. And there you can see, that's it. It's up and down a tree, 20 foot. We'll go get a little closer look at the tree. Well, first, we'll pan down, show you my setup here. So, that's my saddle, trophy line pouch. That pocket holds my bolts. Main compartment holds my my steps and my tether. And that side holds my gear hoist. And once I get up into the tree, it's pretty convenient because I got a pouch, you know, that I can leave a grunt call or snacks. I got two pockets where I can put a bottle of water or put a release real quick, tuck your cell phone. My trophy line pouch has been working real well for me. I've had a chance to hunt out of it a couple times and I like it. You know, the only other thing that I usually do once I get up in a tree that I didn't show you is I didn't put my release on. If I got a release, I'll put it on. If I climb in the dark, I got to take my headlamp off. And, you know, usually I'll take my jacket, my upper body layers. I'll take them out and put them on. But you got to see everything, pulling the bow up, hanging it, hanging the pack. That's everything kind of ready to hunt. And I'll put markers in the video so you can see the, what am I thinking, like the different marks. Like I'll have links where you can just kind of jump to the, the first climb, second climb, third climb. But this is how I hunt. Long as it's legal, long as I can drill, and to me it's just a no-brainer. If you can drill trees, it just goes really well with saddle hunting, whether you're leaving grade 8 bolts in for presets on a private piece of property, or if you're out on core engineer land or something like that and you're just running and gunning. Each time I've walked back to the camera, I've been packed up ready to go. I can walk miles and miles with this setup on. I got my compass right there, so I can refer to that real quick. This is it. Really streamlined. Nothing gets in the way. Just carry your bow and go. Let's look at the tree. I get this mount off. So it is, it's my practice tree. I have limbed it. So it's a telephone pole. Limbs, obviously you have to negotiate around, but it's got a little bit of lean. I don't know if you can see. Once you get up, it starts leaning. Nothing too unmanageable. But anyway, that's it. We're going to wrap it up. We're at 30 minutes. So take it or leave it. Now you know. If you've been sitting on the fence and you didn't know how long it would take you, now you know. And if I can make anything clear, let me know. Happy to explain.